It's all good. That's the beauty of those tournaments. It gets those kids about motivated. Go ahead, sing along. Drum. What's that?
It's a fun element.
It's such a good thing. Yep. And I've heard partial, but I think the back of the best part.
My guess.
Yeah. Hello, son. Hey guys.
What's up, Trouble?
Hello, Rodney. What are you doing?
Thank you.
repping the halftime game.
What's that?
I'm repping the halftime game.
Nice. Good for you. Give me knuckles. Well, enjoy.
Yeah, I missed it.
That's awesome. That's good. Hey, good evening to you, and welcome here to the campus of Montana Tech. Frontier Conference basketball here on KBOW Butte as Montana Tech getting ready to take on the Skylights of MSU Northern. The final day of Frontier Conference action, and this is one of three games that are obviously going on in conference. We'll talk about them all as we continue. The third and final meeting between Montana Tech and Northern. They split this year, and they both won on each other's floor. Montana Tech won the opening matchup up there in the Armory. The Skylights, the last time they were in the building, got the win here. So, JT, we'll see what happens in round three, my man.
Game day, excited for this one. Montana Tech, both of these teams going into the playoffs have to start putting it together. They've got to bring their A game, and they've really got to execute and get ready for this tournament.
Well, and as we start talking about the tournament, one part of it is understood. Montana Tech, who they know who they're playing, they know where they're playing. The Digs will go to Western. That will be on Wednesday of next week. Our assumption is it'll either be a 6 or a 7 o'clock game. We expect those times to be announced tomorrow. But Montana Tech does know that they are going to Western. Now, for the Skylights, they don't know. The top two seeds in the women and, of course, in the men will get first-round byes. So the Skylights will find out who their opponent is by whoever loses in Carroll Providence. That game coming up here in just a few minutes as well.
Well, that's a big advantage for Tech and Western. You know who you're going to face. They knew it earlier in the week. They can watch a lot of film and get prepared. These games are irrelevant now. There isn't much movement can be made in the conference. We know who the byes are. Big deal. I wouldn't even care about this game. I'd get ready for Western.
Well, and I it's a very interesting point because, like I say, they know that that is the case since this past weekend. The top of the pile, there's still a lot of movement to be had. We talked about it last night on overtime quite a bit. But we have three teams tied at the top of the pile. You have Rocky, Providence, and Carroll. All are 11-3 in conference. And Rocky holds the tiebreaker over both Carroll and Providence. They beat both of them two out of the three times. And Rocky they have a game tonight as well. As they will be taking on Western. That game is in Billings. And then Providence and Carroll face off. And that's obviously a huge one. Whoever wins will be co-Frontier Conference champions if Rocky wins. And then Rocky would have the tiebreaker as far as the one seed. And that comes in with home field. You know, you'd have home court throughout the entirety of the Frontier Conference tournament. And we've seen some great crowds here this year. That's going to play a huge factor how this one boils out.
Yeah, no question about it. And the Carroll Providence game's got to be a great matchup. And is that at Carroll or is that at?
That is in Great Falls.
Great Falls. So advantage Great Falls in that one. And then Rocky just got to hold their own and they're going to end up in first place anyway. So upsets have been known to happen in this conference, so we'll see how it plays out.
Yes, indeed. So, again, the standings as of right now, you have Rocky, Carroll, and Providence. All are 11-3. They are all tied coming into tonight's game. After that, you have UM Western in 4. You have Montana Tech at 5, and Northern comes in 6th place right now. Again, Tech and Northern will travel. Tech knows that they're going to Carroll, to Dillon. We just don't know the other side of it as far as Northern goes. So the Skylights come to town. again, the third and final meeting between these two programs here to wrap up the regular season. Not a whole lot has changed here for the Skylights. They're led by Peyton Kerr. She's just having a fantastic year. Peyton averages 15 a game. Latia Lawrence at point guard gets better and better every week. You know, she is a young point guard. She's very active. She is very good. And her ceiling is awfully high to see how good she is going to get for Coach Moe and the Skylights here in the future.
Yeah, well, it's rare for a freshman to come into this conference and make a name for themselves, and she's certainly done that. And Coach Mowat's going to get his turn next year. He's got a lot of them coming back, and he's going to have to recruit a couple good players, and I think he has so far on the books. But Coach Hugh's saying hi to us. I like the future look of this Northern team. I think they're going to be good, and he will get another big. He's got two good ones right now that are going to be good. They're young, need a lot of experience, and that's what he's getting them. He's taking his beatings to prepare for the future.
Well, again, thanks for joining us here on KBOW Butte, KPQX in Haver. Paul Pedisco, John Thatcher, as we get ready for game one of our doubleheader, as we have the women on the floor here first, Montana Tech and the Skylights, and then, of course, the men will wrap up our doubleheader starting at 7 o'clock as the Oredigger men trying to clinch their fist around that tie for first place in the Frontier Conference. They'll be looking for a big win, and Northern has still some wiggle room on the men's side, so a big game for them tonight. As we get ready for this doubleheader. Let's take a quick timeout. We'll come back. We'll talk about both teams, take a look at the starters and more after this two-minute timeout. Here once again to the campus of Montana Tech Frontier Conference basketball here on KBOW Butte, KPQX in Haver. Paul Pedisco, John Thatcher, as we are here on a Thursday, the final night of Frontier Conference play, as the Digs taking on the Skylights. Coach Mowat and company is in town as our women's game getting ready to roll. Montana Tech 12-17 overall, 3-11 in conference play. On the other side, the Skylights come in 8-20 overall, 1-13 in Frontier Conference play. And again, the final weekend, you know, normally we still have a little bit of wiggle room, if you will, some things that can change, but it does feel like the years past, we have a lot more set in stone this year than it feels like we've had in like the last 5 to 10 years in this conference.
Well, the only confusion to the thing is you got the three best teams tied at the top, and today's going to be a difference maker, but the bottom is pretty much sealed in stone. And really, I understand Northern's dilemma. They just were young, inexperienced. They lost a bunch of seniors. Everybody else brought all the seniors back.
Yeah.
You aren't going to win many basketball games. Western has been up and down. Some nights they play outstanding, and other nights they struggle. So the bottom tier has really not evolved into being consistent enough.
Boy, and it's, you know, we look at what the landscape of the Frontier looks like next year, and it's going to be a completely different scenario. We're not going to recognize this conference next year. You know, we talk about at Northern last year, they graduated far and away the most seniors. You know, they lost the most in any program in the Frontier Conference. And next year, every team is going to look completely different. This Montana Tech team will graduate six. You know, you look at teams like Carroll. Providence. The heavy hitters across the board are all going to be gone, and we're going to see a very different team out of everybody and a very different conference as we get started next year.
Well, just looking it over, knowing how much everybody's losing, and that includes Rocky.
Yeah.
Moat might be the team to beat next year.
Truly. I mean, it could be just that easy.
That's how funny this game is.
That's it. So, again, thanks for joining us here as we make our way through a Thursday. Montana Tech taking on the Skylights of MSU Northern again. Right now, Montana Tech number 5 and Northern number 6 in the Frontier Conference. Tech knows where they will go for their playoff next game. And on the other side, the Skylights waiting to find out where they will travel for their playoff game. It could be either Carroll or Providence, and whoever loses that ball game is where they'll be next week. So we're going to get our national anthem. So with it, we'll pause. We're back here to the Hyper after this 2-minute timeout. Welcome back here once again to the campus of Montana Tech Frontier Conference action. KBOW Butte, KPQX in Haver. Let's get this thing ready to roll here, JT. Let's take a look at the starters. We'll start things off with the Skylights out of MSU Northern as Coach Moe brings them into town. They're starting five. You're looking at Latia Lawrence. Lawrence, the 5'9" freshman. She wears number 20, averages 12 a game. She plays a lot of minutes. And the last time they were here, I liked what Montana Tech did against her. They made her dribble the ball, you know, a full 90 feet every possession, knowing that, you know, she was it really at point guard. And I like that. We'll see if they decide to bring a lot of pressure on Latia Lawrence again here tonight.
That is not going to change.
The other starters here for the Skylights tonight, you're looking at Riley Kerr. As Riley Kerr, a 5'10" sophomore. Riley wears number 21. Peyton Kerr, of course, is on the floor as well. As Peyton Kerr is a 5'9" senior, she wears number 24. Their leading scorer at 15 a game, has had just a tremendous career for MSU Northern. Morgan Mason is next. Mason, a 5'8" junior, wears number 31. And Sydney Hovde is down at the block. Hovde, a 6-foot senior, she wears 33 for the Skylights of MSU Northern. Looking forward to the battle in the block. Hovde and Brooke Hagee has historically been an outstanding contest, the two of them inside.
Two real strong post players.
The starting five for Montana Tech. You're looking at Allie Cleverly at point. Cleverly will start at the point today. The last game out, Madison Allen was at point again. They will bring Cleverly back in to start, the sophomore out of Butte High School. She's a 5'7" sophomore, wears number 4. Molly Peoples, one of the seniors playing their final game on this floor today. Peeps, a 5'8" senior, wears number 10. She averages 9 a game for Montana Tech. Danny Urich is next. Urich, a 5'10" junior. She wears number 22, averaging just under 10 a game as well. Tavia Rooney will play out on the wing. Tavia, 5'11" sophomore, averaging 12 points, 10 rebounds a game. And Brooke Hagee is in the block. Brooke, a 6'1" senior, wears number 42, 11 points, 6 rebounds a game for Montana Tech.
Yeah, and as you told me earlier, Yuri needs 5 points to get 1,000-point club. So if I'm coaching her, I'm setting up plays and say, let's get it out of the way, because I'm sure they're going to stop the game and give her the ball.
I was really happy to come across that today. I kind of went digging into it. Danny Urich is 5 points away from the 1,000-point club. Montana Tech will control the tip. Digs into the offensive zone, right to left on your radio dial. Out on the far right side, Allie Cleverly. Montana Tech in their home whites. They feed it into Hagee. Hagee spinning to her left in trouble. Travel call.
Good defense by Hovde. Totally took the left side away, so she couldn't come back with her left hand.
So the Skylights get the ball. Full court pressure. Latia Lawrence has Cleverly all over her. And Lawrence across midcourt, looking to her right, checks it off, goes back to her left, now into the high post to Hovde. Hovde at the right elbow of the key, kicks it back on the far left side to Mason. Morgan Mason now to Lawrence. 13 on the shot clock, 30 seconds gone here in the ball game. Skylights of the basketball. Driving into the high post, it comes out to Morgan. She fires and rattles out. Defensive rebound, Cleverly. Here come the digs in transition. Cleverly drives inside. Ball comes out. Picking it up is Hagee. She'll go in the corner. Three-point shot is on its way. No good, as putting up the deep ball that time was Tavia Rooney. We've seen her pull out the stops from the three-point line more and more each game.
Yep, she's got to get her elbow up. Let me help her out.
Tavia shooting 35% from the three-point line thus far this year. Lawrence down the right side of the paint. Puts it up off the glass. No good. Tavia Rooney with a rebound. Montana Tech the other way. Scoreless thus far in the opening quarter. Far right side, Molly Peoples. Peoples comes across here on the near side. Danny Urich's going to fire. Danny gets it down.
Thank you, Danny. Got three of them out of the way. Atta girl.
That's it. Danny Urich now with 998 points for Montana Tech in her career. And Latia Lawrence across the timeline. Montana Tech leading 3-0. Hovde gets it at the right elbow, passes it out on the edge. Lawrence will look to answer. Back of the rim, no good. Big rebound, Hovde inside. Good position. She'll clear it around, far left side. Now she'll put him in motion. Lawrence passes right, Peyton Kerr. Peyton into the high post, but goes out left side. Jump shot just on the three-point line is Riley Kerr. Boy, Riley standing right on the arc, knocks it down.
Yeah, Tech's helping recovery was too slow.
Montana Tech leading 3-2, digs into the offensive zone. Down to the bottom left corner, driving baseline. Pull-up jumper is up and in. Danny Urich, 5 points. And Montana Tech has another 1,000-point score as Danny Urich gets her 1,000 point for Montana Tech, the third player to get 1,000 points this year. Molly Peoples and also Brooke Hagee both got 1,000 in the game, the first game at Providence this year. The inlet, Hagee tips it, Montana Tech ball.
Great defense by Hagee.
Diggs leading 5-2. Left side, Peoples. Peoples for three. Back of the rim, no. Rebound tips, and Hovde gets it. And we're going to get a whistle and a timeout as Coach Moat not happy when he brings the ladies over to the bench. 7:26 left to play here in the first. Montana Tech leading 5-2.
Yeah, he's not happy because they're not running their stuff. It's not smooth looking. And they've got to do a better job of ball reversal, and they've got to do a better job of sealing off down on the block. Hagee makes a great play because nobody gets a body on her. So you take advantage of mistakes by offensive players.
Well, let's get you up to date on the other scores here. As just underway in Billings, Western leading Rocky 5-3. The Carroll Providence game has no score as of yet. And that's certainly the one that's going to have the magnet. We'll make sure to keep you updated on those scores, especially for our friends listening up in the High Line and Haver. That game will influence who the next opponent for Coach Moat and the Skylights will be in the first round of the playoffs on Wednesday.
That's one of those games where you got to temper emotion. Everybody knows what's on the line there. So whoever comes out showing the most emotion could get themselves in trouble. Yeah. You got to be relaxed.
Skylights will inbound after the timeout. Montana Tech comes out of the huddle. Danny Urich, Molly Peoples, Allie Cleverly, Tavia Rooney, and Brooke Hagee on the floor. Again, Danny Urich with 5 points to start Montana Tech out. Now has 1,000 points in her career coming out of Belt, Montana. Skylights, Hovde in the backcourt. Full court pressure. They get through. Peyton Kerr puts on the brakes, moves it to Lawrence. Lawrence will now set up the offense. She has Mason on her far left wing. Peyton Kerr initially in the bottom right. Drifts up top and gets it. Now she'll rifle it down underneath. Nice pass to Mason, and Mason finishes.
Good job of sealing off. Molly Peoples got caught behind.
Morgan Mason gets her first field goal. Montana Tech leading 5-4. Xavier Rooney now to Cleverly. Cleverly back to Rooney. Rooney outside the arc here on the near side. Around a screen set by Hagee. And we're going to get an offensive. Xavier Rooney bodied up Mason. Morgan Mason stood her ground. And Tavia Rooney will pick up the offensive. And the Skylights will get the ball.
Yeah, Rooney can ill afford to get in foul trouble.
So the Skylights looking to get through the pressure. Montana Tech brings man pressure again. As Lawrence out near midcourt now bringing him into the offense. Peyton Kerr goes bottom left. Instead, she hands it off here on the near side to Riley Kerr. Riley down in the corner. Lawrence, three-point shot blocked, but holding on to it is going to be the Skylights. Hovde comes out with it to Peyton Kerr. Now into Hovde. Tip taken away. Hagee got a hand on it. Hagee with her second tip pass here in the opening quarter. Montana Tech leading 5-4. And Danny Urich leading the Skylights 5-4 as she has all the scoring. Little head fake Cleverly. She's going to drive right side of the paint. Puts it up off balance. Hagee with the offensive glass. Ball is stripped. And she will be fouled as Morgan Mason tried to reach in and take it away.
Hagee doing all the blue-collar things here early in the game. I like to see that. One of the things I like is she's not going body-to-body with the offensive player. And as a result, she's tipped two balls and stolen one.
Peoples,
big plays.
Peoples will go out. Madison Allen will come in here. And Hagee is at the line for the digs. Hagee, a 78% free throw shooter. Her first tier is up and good. So Hagee gets her first points and the first point out of somebody other than Danny Urich. The digs still one of the best teams in the country from the free throw line. They shoot 77% as a team.
That's a great number.
Hagee's second is on the way and it is good. So Hagee goes 2 of 2. And Montana Tech stretches their lead out to 3. Full court pressure. Mason to Lawrence in the backcourt. Montana Tech, great presence in the backcourt. Pass cross the key. It goes out of play. Skylights able to hold on to it as they go to Hovde.
Thought you were going to get hurt there.
Hovde to Lawrence. Lawrence will now set up the offense. As long as they didn't spill my M&Ms, I'm okay. Mason into Hovde. Tipped out again. Hagee almost got another steal. Backdoor cut to Riley Kerr. Riley with a right hand. Up and out, no good. Rebound tipped. Montana Tech basketball. They'll push the pace the other way. Montana Tech into the offensive zone. 5:38 left to play here in the first. Montana Tech leading 7-4. Diggs 4 wide. Down on the block is Hagee. She and Hovde just pounding on each other. They'll lob it into Hagee. About 8 feet out left side. Turns to her right. Puts it up with the right hand. Rolls off the iron. No good. And the Skylights back the other way.
Both post players playing outstanding defense on each other.
Hovde has made it clear she will not let Hagee go with the left hand. Hovde gets it in the high post, turns, fires it out on the left side to Lawrence. Lawrence, a head fake, Cleverly on her defensively. 5 minutes remaining here in the opening quarter. Diggs by 3. Baseline, Riley Kerr, left hand, nice take and gets it.
Good crossover move.
Two outstanding athletes, Riley and Peyton Kerr. Riley's second field goal. The Diggs lead by 1. Montana Tech with the basketball. Tavia Rooney, left side of the paint. She has a step and the easy layup.
Yeah, you got to help on her, and nobody gave a hand.
That might be the part that's overlooked sometimes, how quick she is. Down the floor, Skylights get behind the press. They get the basket and the foul. So Hovde will get the basket, and she will shoot 1.
Higgy made the political mistake of going out to play the dribbler. You've got to realize there's a cutter coming behind you. Just get back in the key. Take your chances on a jump shot. Don't give up a layup.
So Hovde will shoot one, the personal foul on Brooke Heggy. That brings her out, and Nia Falatoy with her first minutes here tonight. Free throw attempt off the front of the rim, no good. Batted around, Northern comes out with it. Good hustle, Peyton Kerr. Took an awkward bounce off the iron. Everybody was in the air, and it came down to Peyton Kerr. So Northern in the offensive side. Lawrence puts up the floater off the glass, no good. And Tavia Rooney gets it off Danny Urich the other way. Urich wide left to Cleverly. Cleverly baseline, stops, comes all the way up top. Left elbow, Tavia Rooney. She'll step back, feeds it into the high post, turning right, stepping back to the left, and Nia Falatoy rolls it in.
Yeah, they left their feet. She took advantage. Nice crossover move.
Tech leading 11-8. Montana Tech with the lead. 4 minutes remaining here in the opening quarter. Mason will hand it off to Lawrence, far left side. Northern trailing by three. Lawrence with the basketball. Yet to score so far here in this opening quarter for the Skylights. They'll run three wide, two down on the block, around a screen. Peyton Kerr down the left side of the paint. Ball fake once, goes up, travel call. So Peyton Kerr called with the walk. That will go back to Montana Tech here. Peyton, actually Riley Kerr will go out. And checking into the ball game is going to be Toms. Savannah Toms with her first minutes tonight.
I really like the things Tech is doing defensively.
So the Digs back after the timeout. Allie Cleverly. Left side, Danny Urich, now up top, Falatoy. She'll lob it down to the block to Rooney. One dribble, turns to her right, puts up the scoop shot, no good. She goes to the ground hard, but she will go to the foul line.
Tech has three players, Urich, Falatoy, and Tavia Rooney. If you leave your feet, they own you because they're so good with that crossover step.
So Tavia Rooney will go to the line here for the Digs. Rooney, 80% from the foul line on the year. And her first is off the front of the rim, no good. Montana Tech leading 11-8. Again, these two teams split on the regular season. They won on each other's floor. And Rooney goes 1 of 2. She has 3 points on the day. So right now, Tech shooting 50% from the floor. They're 4 of 8. Northern 4 of 10 from the floor. Montana Tech full court pressure again. Soder Ice checks into the ball game. Tech has three ladies in the backcourt. Pass to midcourt. Goes left side, Peyton Kerr. Kerr into the lane. Goes to the baseline. It's knocked out of bounds. Good hustle by Madison Allen, who knocks that one clean. So on the floor right now for the Digs, you have Madison Allen, also Soder Rice, Nia Falatoy, Allie Cleverly, and staying out there as well as Danny Urich. The inbound left side, Mason puts up the jumper and knocks it down.
Too easy.
So Morgan Mason gets her second field goal. She has 4 points. The Digs by 2, 12-10. Cleverly going right. Passes that way. Out to Danny Urich. Now up top, Soder Rice. They'll lob it into Falatoy. She'll go to her left hand. Off the glass. No good. Rattled out hard. Skylights the other way. Mason looking down the floor. She'll rifle it into Toms. Toms back up top to Lawrence. They'll readjust the offense. Northern getting through the press here the last couple trips down. Peyton Kerr into the high post to Toms. Toms stops, lobs it deeper into the block. Tipped, Soder Rice got a hand on it. Montana Tech basketball. Tech doing a great job denying the entry pass into the low post right now. Soder Rice from the foul line, no good. Defensive rebound brought in by Crass. So Cheyenne Crass, who played outstanding the last time they were here. She is on the floor here for the Skylights. Peyton Kerr, Lawrence, also Morgan Mason, and Toms rounding out the five for the Skylights. Peyton Kerr attacks with a left-handed scoop shot, no good. Defensive rebound, Digs the other way. Northern not getting any second chance looks right now. And another offensive. Morgan Mason draws her second charge in the last 4 minutes. Madison Allen will pick up the charge.
She was out of control as soon as she hit the top of the key, and that was read real well.
1:59 left to play here in the opening quarter. Montana Tech full court pressure still. Full court man pressure, the inbound. To Crass. Crass moves it across to Peyton Kerr, and Kerr will bring it into the offensive zone. She'll drop it off to Mason, directing traffic. 1:50 left to play here in the first. Digs by 2. Latia Lawrence Drives inside the arc, leaves it to Mason. Mason has the opening, and you might want to get a body on her. Morgan Mason has 7 points. She's a tremendous shooter.
You got to defend her anyway. Nobody guarded her on either one of those last two shots.
Mason is 3 of 4 from the floor. She has 1 3-pointer, 2 inside the arc. She is the leading scorer right now with 7, and the Lights grab their first lead of the day, 13-12. Down to Falatoy. Falatoy, wrap around, off the glass, not enough English off the iron. And the Skylights will get it back the other way. Frontier Conference action here on a Thursday, the final day of Frontier Conference action. Skylights with a basketball. Peyton Kerr just outside the arc on the right wing. Down the right side, Jury Cummings is on her defensively, moves it across. Crass with a jump shot from 14, and Crass knocks it home. Yeah, this is only the second game I've seen of Crass, but I'll tell you, she impressed me in the game the first time here.
She's played real well.
Down the left side, nice take, Madison Allen. Just too much on the layup, bounces off the glass, no good. Skylights in transition. Peyton Kerr gets down, steps through, double-teamed into the high post. Crass, jump shot from the foul line is up and in.
Too many people getting wide-open shots right now for Northern. Coach Sandin's got to call a timeout. They've got to get out and belly up.
Skylights stretch their lead out to 5. Montana Tech with the ball, Jaden Cummings. She'll move it up top to Michaela Cloker, the young lady out of Helena. Soda Rice also out there. Baseline, 3-point shot is up and out, no good. Rebound goes to the ground, picked up by Madison Allen. Montana Tech ball. 8 on the game clock here in the first quarter. Madison Allen drives down the right side of the paint in the corner to Cummings. Cummings fires the 3, no good. And grabbed by the Skylights, and we have 1 in the books. So with 10 minutes in the books, right now the Lights lead by 5. 17-12 as they get a nice run there to end the first. We'll take a timeout. We'll start the second quarter after this 1-minute break. Well, we get the horn. Welcome back here once again. Frontier Conference action. KBOW, Butte, KPQX in Haver. Paul Panisco, John Thatcher. The Skylights up 17-12 as they take advantage of some quick baskets back and forth there. The Skylights shooting 53% as of right now. The other side, Montana Tech, down to 28%. They started out hot and then just couldn't get anything to go there late.
Well, Tech's got to guard the perimeter better. They're getting some wide-open looks. I mean, they had 3 shots, two threes and a single. They've got to get out and cover.
Lawrence across midcourt for the Skylights. Left to right on your radio. Skylights wearing the road black with a maroon and gold trim. Morgan Mason drifts out to the left wing. Looking to enter, does so, drops it down on the block to Tom. Tom with the right hand, puts it up and out, no good. Good defensive pressure, Tavia Rooney. Forced her to really adjust her shot that time, and here come the digs the other way. Skylights leading 17-12. Skylights shooting 50% so far here in the first half. They get it down inside. Hagee will get around. Hagee with the left hand rolls it in.
New defensive post player didn't take away her left push.
9:20 left to play here in the first half. Lights by 3 as they get into the offensive zone. Crass at the top of the horn, backs it out to Mason. Morgan Mason directing traffic right now. Picks up her dribble. Good defensive pressure by Cloker. Comes here on the near side to Lawrence. Lawrence into the high post to Crass. Wasn't the intended target. Underneath to Tom. Tom spins. Fires no good. Hagee with a rebound. Boy, nobody getting any real second chance looks right now in the first half. Cloker, far right one. Comes out to the wing. Gets it back in the corner. Cloker, head fake. Drives through the lane.
Push.
Yep, going to get a push call.
Push or travel, had to be one or the other.
God, she gets bailed out, I think, there. As the shove call will go on, looks like Skunk Cap was this Oh, she is out there. I apologize. I didn't see Skunk Cap come in. And Skunk Cap picks up the whistle. And the lob pass comes out to Danny Urich. Urich at the foul line. Jump shot is on its way and good. Danny Urich adds two more. She has 7 points right now.
Coach Mott really unhappy with that. They did not cover her at all.
Lights by one, 17-16. Hovde getting ready to check back in for the Lights. Morgan Mason drives out on the left wing. Wide open, three-point shot, no good. Tavia Rooney gets another rebound. Here comes Tech in transition. Down the floor, into the paint. Pull-up jumper is up and in again for Danny Urich.
Girl doesn't shoot enough. I tell you that every game.
That is the case. So she has officially gone over 1,000 for her career. She has 9 points currently in this ball game. And if you're keeping track at home, 1,004 for her career. Lawrence on the far right wing. Comes up top. Pass moves it into the hands of here on the near side to Lawrence, Lawrence moves it out, Skunk Cap. Skunk Cap drives down the right side of the paint. Good take to the basket, shot no good. Hagee blocking out, gets the rebound. Boy, Rooney and Hagee doing a fantastic job rebounding. Rooney goes coast to coast, gets the basket, was looking for the foul.
That is a great job of running the floor.
Davey Rooney with 5 points. Montana Tech now up by three. 20-17. We've seen some seesaw action, some quick runs back and forth here. Lawrence to Skunk Cap, left side. Morgan Mason's going to fire from way downtown off the front of the rim, no good. Rebound Montana Tech in transition. Far left side controlling. Now they feed it down on the block to Hagee. Hagee turns, fires, and gets it. Brooke Hagee with 6 points. 6 feet away on the baseline, left side, knocked it down.
Good entry pass into the block on the floor.
7 minutes remaining here in the first half. Tech leads by five. Boy, we've seen some quick 10-point runs on both sides right now. 3-point shot is up and no good there for Crass. Offensive rebound back to Crass, 10 feet away this time, and she knocks it down from the left side of the key. Cheyenne Crass with 6 points coming off the bench here for the Skylights. Diggs leading 22-19. Montana Tech with the ball. Left side, Molly Peoples outside the arc. Around a high screen, Molly top of the key, picks up her dribble, feeds it into Tavia. Tavia, follow-away jumper is no good. Rebound Skylights back the other way. Morgan Mason has a lane, puts on the brakes at the baseline, out to Lawrence. 3-point shot is up and short. And a defensive rebound by Danny Urich, and Tech will put the pedal to the floor again. Coast to coast, cleverly puts it high off the glass, no good. She came down awkwardly and looks like possibly rolled an ankle. 16-12 left to play here in the first half. The pace of this thing is in the red right now.
It really is. But, you know, transition's been pretty good. But when they get to half-court basketball, both teams have got to shore it up defensively.
Skylights. Lawrence gets the ball, backing up. Allie cleverly right in front of her. Lawrence into the offensive zone. Bounce pass to Hovde. Goes cross-court to Lawrence. No opening for her. She'll stop, come up top. Skunk Cap controlling. 5:55 left to play here in this first half. Montana Tech up 22-19. Ball fake, Peyton Kerr into the post. Pass goes left. Now back inside to Peyton. Peyton with a right hand, puts it up off balance, gets it down from 7 feet away.
That is a great jump hook.
Great athleticism by the senior for the Skylights. Diggs' lead is one, 22-21. Montana Tech, left side, Danny Urich. 9 points on the day. Danny drives, pass comes up to the wing. Molly Peoples from downtown, no good. Brooke Hagee with the offensive glass. She turns and fires. It rolls out. It goes to the ground, picked up by the Skylights. Tech with a couple good looks at it. Here come the Skylights in transition. Far right wing controlling Skunk Cap. 3-point shot, no good. Rebound controlled in traffic by Cleverly. And she'll pick up the pace the other way. Cleverly. Top of the horn, now drifts to the left wing. Bounce pass goes inside to Hagee, one-on-one with Hovde. Pass tipped, Soda Rice able to track it down. Soda to Cleverly, Cleverly from downtown, rattles out. And that one brought in by the Skylights.
Both teams go on streaks, then everything stops.
Cleverly shooting 45% from the three-point line here this year. And Danny Urich gets a toe on a pass, so the Skylights will get the boot call, and they'll keep it in their offensive zone. 4:38 left to play here in this first half. We have a timeout on the floor. The Diggs lead by one, 22-21 over the Skylights. Frontier Conference action here on KBOW Butte. We'll take a timeout. We are back to the Hyper after this 1 minute break.
mud boots are perfect for all-day wear with shock-absorbing insoles to keep your feet dry and ache-free. Better yet, they're waterproof. Add a Carhartt or area jacket to your everyday wear, and you'll see why they're meant for winter. Shop News Murdoch Ranch and Home Supply at 3939 Harrison Avenue or online at Murdoch.com.
They go the extra mile. They exceed expectations. They go above and beyond the call of duty. They over-deliver. Napa Auto Parts is your trusted source for automotive parts, accessories, and know-how for your car, truck, SUV, and heavy-duty vehicles. It's their goal to always do the little things right, making Napa one of the most comprehensive car care brands in the U.S. For quality parts and then some, visit Napa Auto Parts at 3703 Harrison Avenue in the Tamarack Square in Butte. They build hydraulic and air conditioning hoses, too.
Welcome back here once again to the Great Western Hyper Frontier Conference action. KBOW Butte, KPQX in Haver. The other game's underway right now. Providence leading Carroll 25-17. That one about 2 minutes into the second. And Rocky leading Western 29-18 in about that same time frame.
So Rocky had a big run.
So Skylights with the basketball. Latia Lawrence at the top of the horn moves it out on the left side as Prather is on the floor. Prather wearing the headband. She'll come back out and get it on the left wing. Prather drives to the baseline. Stop comes out on the edge. Now gets it back. Skylight's really overloading that left side of the floor, and it's going to be a shot clock violation. Never even really looked up to the rim. Shot clock violation will go to the Digs.
One of the things as a coach I always liked, I wanted ball reversal around the horn, and they impacted themselves in that corner and got themselves in trouble. You got to get it around, make the defense move.
4:15 left to play in the first half. Tech by one. Up top controlling Madison Allen. She passes right as she goes there to Danny Urich. Urich now to Cleverly. Cleverly baseline take. Stops. Double team. Comes out to Soda Rice. Three-point shot. Rice. Front of the rim. No good. Hovde with a rebound. Hovde will clear it off to Mason, and Mason back the other way. 3:54 left to play here in this second quarter. Bounce pass to Hovde at the left elbow with a key. Knocked away. And a Falatoy
had a call on Northern and a push.
Yeah. Falatoy got the steal, but there was a push call inside on Morgan Mason. That's her second personal. So Mason gets her second personal foul. Sorry, I'm kind of looking over to Coach and see if he's going to bring her out or not.
Well, he's wondering what the call was, but she blatantly pushed on the play. I was looking right at it.
3:35 left to play here in the first half. Allen, bounce pass on the interior. Nia Falatoy stretches through the double team. Her layup attempt, no good. Hovde gets the rebound. And Hovde down the floor. Hovde will bring it across the timeline. Montana Tech by one. Mason, bounce pass underneath. Nice feed inside to Riley Kerr. Her first attempt, no good. Goes to the right hand this time. And her second is good. Riley Kerr has 6 points. And the Lights grab the lead back. 23-22. Digs with the basketball, far right wing. They'll feed it inside to Falatoy. Double team. Falatoy spins, goes to the baseline, wraps it out to Rice. Rice in the corner, three-pointer, no good. Hovde will grab the rebound. Montana Tech right now, 1 of 8 from the three-point line. And the Skylights lead by one. Riley Kerr to Hovde. Hovde goes left side to Mason, now inside. And a whistle and a foul as Riley Kerr put up the shot. She was shoved out of bounds. And Soda Rice will be called to the personal.
Everything about that play was great. The ball movement was outstanding. The screens were right on target. Freed up the shooter.
So the personal foul on Rice. That is her first. And Riley Kerr will go to the line. I would be shocked if she's not an outstanding free throw shooter. 75% on the year.
That is outstanding, in case you're interested.
Riley Kerr, 6 points so far here in this ball game. And her first rims out, no good. Lights leading 23-22. The Lights, that is their second free throw attempt. They're 0 of 2 from the free throw line thus far. Her second one goes through. Riley Kerr with 7 points. Also, Morgan Mason has 7. And the Lights lead by 2. 24-22. Montana Tech with the basketball. Here on the near side, Tavia around the screen. And the ball blocked. Montana Tech comes out with it. Boy, I apologize. I thought I heard a whistle when Tavy Rooney went around the edge and hit the ground.
What happens, the girl got the hand on top of the ball. It forced her to fall down, and then there's a grab over here.
Yeah, I swore I heard a whistle for some reason, so I basically stopped too.
I could see me saying that at my age. I can't see you saying
that. That was strange. Tavy Rooney gets the inbound around a screen, drifts down to the corner. Now back up top to Cleverly, inside to Hagee. Hagee turns to her right, puts it up off the glass. Shot no good. Good defensive pressure again by Hovde. The Lights leading by two, back the other way.
That's a matchup of power post players.
Back into the offensive side here for the Skylights. Latia Lawrence goes to the right elbow there to Prather. Prather feeds it inside to Hovde, and Hovde finishes. Soft touch by Hovde. She has 4 points. The Lights lead by four. Montana Tech back into the offensive zone. Far right side, Cleverly. She goes there to Urich. Cross court here on the near side is Madison Allen. They go into the high post. First shot no good. Hagee gets the rebound. Triple teamed. Back to Tavy Rooney. Rooney attacks. Whistle and a foul. Hubdy's going to pick up the personal, I believe. Nice take by Tavy Rooney.
I absolutely love how hard Tavy Rooney goes to the bucket. Collision does not matter to her.
Yeah. Hovde gets her first personal. And at the line, Tavy Rooney. She's one of two from the free throw line today. Allen will go out. Peoples will come in. Cleverly, Peoples at the foul line. You have Tavy Rooney, Danny Urich, and Brooke Hagee in the key. Tavy is first off the front of the rim. No good. So Tavy Rooney will shoot one more here. The Digs, 3 of 5 from the foul line so far. Tavia's second is money. She has 6 points. 1:35 left to play here in this first half. The Lights lead by three, 26-23. Skylights with the basketball across midcourt. Sally Cleverly tried to reach in and wrestle it away, and she'll pick up the personal.
Yeah, I didn't know which way that was going to go because they pushed off right after she reached.
So the Skylights limbound right at the end of the Montana Tech bench. Lawrence has Cleverly on her. Montana Tech man-to-man. Pass up top to Riley Kerr. Now into the high post to Hovde. She'll attack. Hovde's shot no good, but she is fouled. Strong take by Hovde. And the personal foul going to go on Danny Urich.
Yeah, that should be a play that should be non-existent. Anytime they set a screen, that post is going to come. You got to jam her and hold her back. Too easy to get to the bucket.
1:19 left to play here in the first half. The Lights by three, 26-23, and Hovde at the line. She's 0 of 1. Her first tier is up and good. Hovde has 5 points so far on the day. The Skylights are 2 of 4 from the foul line. Her second rattles in. 6 points for Sydney Hovde, and the Lights go up by six. That's their biggest lead of the day. Montana Tech with the basketball here on the near side. They enter into the high post. As Falatoy leaves it for Peoples, she'll fire, and Molly gets another one.
Just a matter of time for her.
She had the opening, and Molly Peoples made that one look easy as Molly knocks it down. 41% three-point shooter and nearly a 40% three-point shooter in her career here at Montana Tech. We'll talk about that at halftime a little bit more. Pass down to the bottom right corner with it. As it comes up top, step back. Lawrence going to fire the three. Front of the rim, no good. Rebound, Montana Tech. Ton of time here as they go the other way. 38 seconds remaining in the first half. 35 on the game clock, and we're down to 21 on the shot clock. A difference of about 12 seconds. Montana Tech trailing by two. Cleverly at midcourt. She has Peoples on her right. Falatoy, bottom right side of the key. Tavy Rooney drifts to the bottom left. Danny Urich comes up to get it. Urich, top of the key, three-pointer blocked. Inside, Falatoy grabs it. She lost it, moves it to the wing. Cleverly from downtown, and she gets it at the buzzer. Allie Cleverly drains the three. Montana Tech goes up 29-28, 3 seconds. Trying to get it down the floor. They'll lob it from 70 feet, and that is going to be no good. And actually, they stop it with 0.2 seconds remaining on the clock. So they don't whistle the half done. They stop the clock with 0.2 seconds, and now the half is done. 29-28 our score. Montana Tech over the Skylights of MSU Northern by one. Frontier Conference action. KBOW Butte, KPQX in Haver. We'll take a break. We'll come back. We'll run you through the numbers and more after this two-minute timeout. Hey, we're back here once again at the campus of Montana Tech as we are at the half of game one of our doubleheader as the Digs up 29-28 here, JT. We'll get into the numbers, team numbers, the individual numbers and that more as we continue. But give us your take on the first 20 minutes, brother.
Well, I thought it was a sloppy basketball game. Both teams have got to go in and talk about defense. It's not like you got a hand in your face. Everybody's wide open shooting the basketball on the perimeter. That last three-pointer by Tech, big-time shot, and it was a scurry shot, and there was absolutely nobody to cover. You've got to play your man and then do your help and recover and get back to your man. Neither team doing a great job of defending the perimeter right now, and they're also Tech is getting the ball down on the block, and they're getting a lot of looks, but they're missing a lot of bunnies. You got to put those in, and of course, when you're struggling from the three-point line and you're missing bunnies, you got yourself in a basketball game. So both of them defensively have to go in and talk about changes.
Well, let's get you updated on the other games first, and then we'll talk numbers. The other two games underway, the Carroll-Providence game, basically at the half. Providence leads that 36-26. And the other game, about 1 minute remaining in the first half, Rocky all over Western, 45-25. So those are the other two games. Again, Providence leading Carroll by 10 at the half, that one in Great Falls.
Well, both scores are interesting. I really thought Western might put up a better fight, and they might before it's all over.
Yeah.
But when you're down by 20 at halftime, you dug yourself a pretty good hole. And the other game is a shocker to me. I really expected Carroll to win this. And Providence is up. And they're good for a couple games, and they're down. And obviously they came. They know that they get to sit home for free if they win this.
Well, let's take a look at our numbers here in the Mining City. We'll start things off for the Skylights. They have two ladies with 7 points each. Riley Kerr has seven. She has three field goals inside the arc. She's 1 of 1 from the foul line. And Morgan Mason with 7 points. All of Mason's in that first quarter. She has two field goals inside the arc, a three-pointer as well. Sydney Hufty has 6 points, 2 field goals, 2 of 3 from the free throw line right now. Cheyenne Crass with 6 points, all basically point blank. Peyton Kerr with a basket for two for the Skylights. Looking at the Skylights numbers, a couple things jump out of you. Peyton Kerr with 1 basket, 2 points, and Latia Lawrence, who averages 12 a game, no points right now. So Montana Tech game plan in the first half certainly working to what they try to get those two just to slow them down, at least in the scoring column.
Well, Northern's not getting anything out of the block. Latia Lawrence has got to go to the hoop more. They're getting some occasional shots from their perimeter players. Be real honest with you, they're fortunate to be in this game. Latia Lawrence has got to take control. If you remember last game, she didn't score for three quarters and had 15 in the fourth quarter, and they walked out of here with the win. So they're going in and talk to her a little bit.
On the other side for Montana Tech, right now leading scorer is Danny Urich. 9 points for Danny. She got Montana Tech's first 5 points, and those first 5 points obviously historic in the fact that those 5 points gave her 1,000 in her career. So Danny Urich, leading scorer for Montana Tech right now with 9 points. You're looking at Tavia Rooney with 6. Tavia is 2 of 4 from the foul line. She has 2 field goals as well. Brooke Hagee with 6 points, 2 field goals, 2 of 2 from the line. Nia Falatoy has a basket for 2. Allie Cleverly and Molly Peoples each have a 3-ball for their scoring thus far here in the first half.
Yeah, and both teams have got to find somebody that can come out and get a hot hand. Molly Peoples hit a 3 that really dug them out of a hole. I think you said they were like 1 for 9 or something. Yep. At the time. She hits a big 3, and then they get a big 3 out of their point guard. But I just don't like the way either team is running their offense. I like they're going inside, but I also, Northern is really trying to cram down on that thing, and I'd like to see some inside out. Catch it, look, kick it out, get it back if you have to, but kick it out and give some driving lanes to your perimeter players.
Some of the team numbers right now, Northern shooting 40% from the floor. They're 12 of 30. Montana Tech 11 of 33 from the floor, shooting 33%. We talked about the three-point line. Montana Tech's percentage went up drastically with a couple of big threes there late. Montana Tech at 27% from the three-point line. Northern is 1 of 11 from the three-point line at 9% as of right now. Free throw line, Northern 3 of 5 for 60%. Montana Tech 4 of 6 for 67%. Turnover number, a huge one for Montana Tech. The Digs, only 1 turnover in that first half. And that's, I mean, obviously turnovers are going to affect every team in the country. I don't care what level you're at, but this Montana Tech team has been hit by turnovers historically, and they have taken some losses because of turnovers. With only one turnover in the opening 20 minutes, that's an outstanding start for the Digs.
Well, that tells you what both teams are doing. They're letting everything happen around the perimeter. You got to get out and deny or force them to keep the ball on one side of the floor. And they're not. Neither team is getting out and getting a hand in the passing lane, and you're not going to see a lot of turnovers.
Rebounding margin, Northern holds a one rebound advantage right now. 20 total rebounds, 5 offensive, 15 defensive. Montana Tech on the other side right now, 19 total rebounds, 6 offensive, and 13 defensive rebounds for the Digs as of right now. And that's kind of how the team numbers stack up here. You know, I talked about Danny Urich. She's 4 of 5 from the floor. She has 9 points. On the other side, you're looking at Riley Kerr. She's 3 of 6 from the floor. She has 7 points. Also with 7 points is Morgan Mason. She was 3 of 5 from the floor. She was fantastic in the first 10 minutes, and I don't even feel like we called her name in the second quarter.
I think she may have touched the ball once or twice. That was it. But again, let's go back to the perimeter. She was left wide open 3 times. She made all 3 shots. And maybe Tech talked about it, and they're getting out and guarding her. I haven't paid that close attention to it.
Well, again, thanks for joining us here as Montana Tech taking on the lights of MSU Northern. It is Senior Day here. The women actually celebrated Senior Day this past weekend due to the fact that it was easier for a lot of families to come in on the weekend. The men are celebrating Senior Day tonight, and certainly looking forward to what should be a great one here. As the Digs lead by 1, 29-28. We have some young kids from East Middle School playing on the court here at the half. They will in the men's game as well. Certainly great to see here as these young athletes having some fun on the floor. Let's do this. Why don't we take a break, ladies and gentlemen? KBOW KPQX. We'll come back. We'll talk about our seniors. We'll talk about the second half and more after this 2-minute timeout. Hey, we are back here once again. Frontier Conference action on a Thursday, the final day of the regular season here at the Frontier Conference, as a Montana Tech hosting the Skylights of MSU Northern, a 1-point lead for the Digs. As we mentioned, final home game, Senior Day here. Tremendous group that were honored here this past weekend for Montana Tech. But it says an awful lot when you have 3 ladies in this graduating group of seniors, if you will, that have gone over the 1,000-point mark. You know, you look at Molly People and the career she has had, not only at Montana Tech, but in Butte, Montana, and what she was able to do at Butte Central. She is over 1,000 points. Let me check here. Molly Peoples Also went over the 1,000-point mark. That going back to her JC career as well here at Montana Tech. She's over 1,000 points. And as we mentioned, Danny Urich came into this ballgame with 995 points. She has 9 so far here tonight for the Digs.
And those field goals all those girls made encompass about 1% of the shots they've taken over their lifetime.
Yeah.
They have taken just working out and getting better at what you do. It's amazing. And to reach that pinnacle is really a tribute to these girls.
So a one-point lead here for the Digs, 29-28. Frontier Conference action here on a Thursday. The playoffs will start next week, and we'll certainly talk about that more as we continue. But the ladies, both teams are out getting warmed up here for the second half. For the Skylights of MSU Northern, you find yourself down by 1. You were up by 5. You were up by 6. You were up by 7, multiple times. What's important for the Skylights to get rolling here in the second half?
This whole half is about defense. Whoever shores up their defense is going to win this basketball game. Whoever makes most free throws is going to win this basketball game, because both of them did not play textbook defense, and even though the score is low, it does not indicate how easy both teams are allowed to run their offenses right now. You got to contest and force teams to do things they don't want to do.
Well, let's take a look at the Montana Tech side of the basketball. What's important for them to get established early? You lead by 1. What do you want to get going?
I want Danny Urich to shoot the ball 20 times this half. The girl is hot, and she's just such an unselfish player, to the point it drives me crazy as a coach. I mean, I would design plays for that girl. And then Tavia Rooney's got to get a lot more involved in the offense. She's doing a good job of going to the hole, but she doesn't seem to be getting the ball enough. Those are the two leaders on this basketball team. Those are the two that are going to be the difference makers in the second half.
Rebounding numbers individually, I don't think I brought them up as far as both teams for Northern. Sydney Hovde, leading rebounder right now for the Lights. She has 8 rebounds, 6 total points. She's done an outstanding job. And on the other side for Montana Tech, Brooke Hagee has 6 rebounds. Tavia Rooney also has 6 rebounds. So 6 rebounds, 6 points for both of those athletes to this point.
You know, as an old-style coach, I absolutely love it when Tavia Rooney gets a rebound. Her outlet passes are right
instantly.
Now. It is right now, and get it and go. And a couple times she actually made the outlet and beat the defense down the floor and got scores out of the deal. So we'll see what happens here. I think Rooney and Urich got to show up this half.
So a one-point lead for the Digs. Talking about needing points, as we mentioned at the half, Peyton Kerr, the leading scorer for the Skylights, averages 15 a game. She has 2 right now, and Latia Lawrence averages a dozen. She does not have a point yet for the Skylights of MSU Northern right now.
And that was all discussed at halftime.
Yep. So a one-point lead for the Digs. As we get ready for the second half, let's take a look at this scoreboard again. Get you some halftime numbers before we get started here in the third. Let's see here. Yeah, we'll track them down here as we go. Carroll trailing Providence. Providence is up 36-27. And Rocky all over Western 45-28. I was told Chloe Thatcher had 25 in the first half of that ball game.
Her arm will be sore for the rest of the week.
From shooting or from patting herself on the back?
From shooting.
Okay.
Oh, no, she doesn't. She's pretty good about that.
I know. I'm kidding.
But I would if I was her. Good shot.
I know. That's so. Oh, my. Moving on. Montana Tech by 1. 29-28. Digs with the basketball. Left to right on your radio dial. Ball to the left corner. As down there with it, Danny Urich around a screen. She'll drive the lane. Danny to the rack, gets it up and in.
I like her involvement immediately. Her and Rooney touch the basketball.
11 points for Danny Urich. She is the leading scorer on the floor. Back the other way, Mason running the point right now. Enters to the right elbow, turning, bodying up is Riley Kerr. Riley. Pass goes across to Hovde. She'll fire from there and gets it just outside the free throw line. Sydney Hovde, she has 8 points.
Again, nobody contesting the shot. You and I could make those. Well, you.
You could. Hovde hasn't missed yet today. She's 4-4. Montana Tech with the basketball, leading by 1. Tavia Rooney, far right wing, drops it down in the corner to Cleverly. Cleverly comes all the way up top, continues all the way to the left side. Stops in the corner. 8 on the shot clock. Cleverly enters into Hagee, taken away by Hovde. Hovde will get the steal. Again, that's only the second turnover for Montana Tech here in this ball game.
Hovde had a tough game when she's here last time in Butte. She's playing real well here today.
Just underway here in the third quarter. Montana Tech leads by 1. They get it into Hovde. Hovde goes up and is fouled by Brooke Hagee. I love these two inside together. Oh, it's a battle.
That is a battle.
So Hovde will shoot two.
Strong girls.
Hovde has 8 points on the day. She's 2 of 3 from the free throw line. And she'll get ready for her first attempt here in the second half. Front of the rim, no good. 8:49 left to play here in this third quarter. Hovde will get the ball for attempt number two. Digs by one. Hovde, chance to tie us up, and she makes it happen. That's the first time we have been tied here since the opening whistle. We've had lead changes, but never tied. 31 all as of right now. Into the offensive zone, Molly Peoples drops it to Cleverly. Cleverly calls out the offense. Mason will meet her on the left wing. Up top to Peoples, now into the high post to Danny Urich. Urich down the right side, steps through, attacks, shot taken away as Riley Kerr gets the block and takes it the other way.
That was outstanding defense. She just put both hands up. She couldn't go over the top.
8:20 left to play here in the third quarter. Latia Lawrence controlling. She goes to Hovde at the right elbow, now down to the block to Peyton Kerr. Peyton spins to her right, drops it off underneath, and her shot no good. Gets her own rebound back up, no good. Molly Peoples will clear it out for the Digs. Back the other way, Cleverly drifts out to the left wing. 5 feet beyond the arc, up top, Tavia Rooney. Rooney switches to the left hand, fires from the foul line, front of the rim, no good. Defensive rebound brought in by Riley Kerr. Kerr to Lawrence, back the other way. Montana Tech shooting 33% from the floor. They're 12 of 36 on the game. Skylights out to Peyton Kerr. She does track it down and save it as it almost went into their bench, but she throws it to the Montana Tech Oredigers. Diggs in transition. They'll roll it into T attacks, and her shot no good. Tavia Rooney originally went to the left, cut back to her right, put it up off the glass, no good.
Great defense. She made her stay on the floor. She did not leave her feet. Rooney would have had an easy layup.
One field goal for both teams thus far here in the third quarter. Pass almost taken away up top. Peyton Kerr now down in the deep corner, now inside to Hovde. Hovde wraps around, kicks it out. Riley Kerr through the lane, has a shot. Puts it up, and that one off balance, no good. Hagee with the rebound, Tech the other way.
Good defense, Rooney.
Cleverly, it's going to go coast to coast. She'll attack. Ball gets stripped out, and a jump ball call as Morgan Mason got both hands on the basketball.
I like the call.
So the jump ball possession arrow will favor the Skylights here. 6:53 left to play in this third quarter. Morgan Mason plays hard.
Absolutely, she plays hard.
Peyton Kerr down the floor to Mason. Mason across the timeline. 31 all our score. Frontier Conference action here on your hometown station. As Mason moving to her right, just outside the arc. Steps inside, bounce pass up top to Hovde. Hovde moves it out on the far left wing. Now up top to Mason. Mason drives down the left side of the paint, kicks it in the corner. 3-point shot, Riley Kerr, no good. Rebound Cleverly back the other way. Cleverly will wait for the offense to join her. Again, still only one field goal by both teams here in this third quarter. Danny Urich outside the arc, left wing. They'll set a screen up top. Danny's going to fire. Danny Urich from downtown, no good. Hagee hustles after the rebound, and she'll be called with the push as Mason went to the ground. So Brooke Hagee going to pick up her third personal, and that will go to the Skylights. Hagee will pick up her third personal foul. And now she'll come out. Nia Falatoy will come in. Both teams trying to get something going offensively here in the third. We have one field goal both ways. 31 all our score. Full court pressure applied by Montana Tech. Mason in the backcourt. Mason dribbling to her right as she comes across the timeline. Molly Peoples on her defensively. Mason going right, down in the corner. Now comes up top, Lawrence. Lawrence steps back, 5:50 left to play here in the third. Pass goes wide left to Peyton Kerr on the wing. Peyton in the high post, stops, kicks it up top. Now back to Lawrence, 3-point shot, up and out, no good. Rebound tipped, and it goes right into the hands of Riley Kerr, and she'll finish.
Got to get up and clear that board.
Riley Kerr has 9, the Lights grab the lead. Our fifth lead change here of the contest. Lights up 33-31. Montana Tech with a basketball trailing by 2. Molly Peoples around a screen. Pass goes right side to Cleverly. Skylights man-to-man defense as of right now. Cleverly on the wing, down in the corner. And now they feed it inside to Falatoy. She'll wrap around to the baseline, try to pass it through the paint. It comes up. They move it out to Peoples. Peoples fires. That one goes long out of play. Turnover to the Skylights.
Well, both teams have picked up the defense on both ends, and they're getting out on the shooters, and that's made a difference, and that's why nobody's putting the ball in the hoop right now.
Still only one field. Let me check that off. Northern has two field goals here this quarter. Montana Tech with one. 4-2 our score this quarter. And down the floor, across the timeline, controlling Latia Lawrence. To Hovde. Now hands it off to Peyton Carr around the screen. Peyton stops 10 feet away. Passes tipped. Goes to the ground as Rooney knocked it in the air. And we'll get bodies diving after the loose basketball. Possession arrow will favor the Digs. 4:50 remaining here in this third quarter. MSU Northern leading Montana Tech 33-31. Frontier Conference action. KBOW, KPQX with the timeout. We'll take one. We're back here after this 1 minute break. Guide you through the real estate process. Call today, 43-31 our score. The Skylights up over Montana Tech on KBOW Butte, KPQX in Haver. Paul Panisco, John Thatcher. The other game's underway right now. Providence leading Carroll 43-36 for Providence. Parker Ezri with 19 points right now.
Go to the block, coach. Go to the block.
As a Providence up 41-34. Rocky leading Western 49-28 in our other Frontier Conference game tonight. Here in Butte, Skylights by two. Montana Tech with the basketball. Tavia Rooney, baseline left side, comes up top. Urich around the horn right side into the hands of Madison Allen. Allen around a screen, drifts all the way through the paint. Backs it out to Cleverly. Cleverly looking on the inside. Pass to Allen. Gets knocked down. I don't think Allen saw it coming initially. And it's going to be taken away. Morgan Mason. She picks it up. Gets the elbows up. And here come the Skylights back into their offensive zone.
Latia Lawrence still has not gotten into the scoring column, has she?
No, she has not. Pass on the inside. Knocked out of bounds as getting a hand on that one was Nia Falatoy. Let me look here. Lawrence is 0-7. I was going to say she maybe had four or five shots, but 0-7 from the floor right now for Lawrence.
She took some long-distance threes, I know.
So Lawrence looking to inbound, comes all the way out to Mason. 4:10 left to play here in the third. Both teams trying to get some offense here. Morgan Mason attacks, and she'll be fouled as Nia Falatoy will pick up the personal.
Yeah, she was in great position to draw the charge and decided to check it. Got a body on her.
Montana Tech led 29-28 at the half since then. We have a 5-2 ball game. Northern outscoring Montana Tech 5-2 this quarter with 4 minutes left to play here in the third.
Whoever can come up with the big run is going to make the difference in this game.
Boy, and we had several pretty big runs, honestly, in that first half. We saw 5-point leads on one side go to 5-point leads on the other side real quick-like. Mason goes 1 of 2 from the foul line. She has 8 points. Lights by three. Madison Allen across midcourt. Allen, 3-point lead for the Skylights. Allen, bounce pass to Tavia Rooney. Around a screen, Rooney bounces off one defender. Fouled away. Her jump shot no good. Rebound by the Skylights.
Great help defense to prevent Rooney from getting to the hoop.
Montana Tech, one field goal this quarter. Mason moving right. Peyton Kerr gets it outside the arc. Kerr. Looking on the interior, drives into the paint, puts it up with the right hand off balance. No good. Rooney gets the rebound, and she'll be fouled as Riley Kerr tried to reach in and take it away.
That is a great board.
She's just a monster rebounding.
She actually showed signs of violence on that rebound. That was impressive. That's how I like rebounders to be. Go get it.
I don't think I've ever heard you sound that happy in my entire life.
I love good rebounding.
Skylights by three. Danny Urich from the left elbow. Her jump shot no good. Rebound by the Skylights. Montana Tech can't buy one right now. Under 30% shooting for the ball game. They have one field goal this quarter. Lawrence drifting right. Feeds it in the corner. Now into Peyton Kerr. Kerr to the basket. She'll roll it in with the right hand. Peyton Kerr with 4 points. And the Skylights go up by five. Almost taken away. Morgan Mason. Oredigger's back the other way.
Got to pass the ball. They got numbers.
Tavi Aruni. She'll go right to the rim. Her layup won't go. Rebound by the Skylights. Boy, again, Montana Tech just can't wrestle the cover off the rim right now. Montana Tech into the offensive zone. Mason out of the right wing. Drifts up top. Backdoor cut. And that one's going to be thrown to no one as Riley Kerr, the intended target. She wanted the backdoor cuts, and Riley did not leave her feet.
They've probably tried 5 to 6 backdoor plays, and Tech has taken them away every time.
2:35 left to play here in this third quarter. Mason will go out. Skunk Cap will come in. For the Digs right now, Tavi Aruni, Allie Cleverly, Nia Falatoy. Down in the bottom right corner is Madison Allen. And now we're going to get a timeout as Danny Urich, our fifth, on the floor. Go ahead.
I'm sorry. I think this is a great timeout simply because they're not scoring the basketball. And sometimes a timeout will get rid of that business and get you back in the game.
Yeah, you look at the pace in that first half. You know, 29-28, Tech led by one. And right now here in the third quarter, Northern outscoring Montana Tech 8-2 with 2 minutes 30 seconds remaining in the quarter.
Yeah, well, you got to have the right people. You know, you want your best players with the basketball. I still think Danny Urich doesn't handle it enough. And I would really like to see her and Rooney. Rooney's got to start going to the bucket. She's being really too conservative.
The other game's underway. Carroll starting to reel in Providence. Providence leads 45-43. That one just a little bit farther out than we are, about 4 minutes remaining in the third. So, again, Providence up 45-43. Rocky Mountain College leading Western 56-33 in the other game. So Rocky wins that one. They are the number one seed, period. They'll be co-champions in the Frontier Conference with whoever wins the Carroll-Providence game due to the fact that Rocky owns the tiebreaker over both of those schools. They will be the number one seed if they're able to hold on and take down Western tonight.
I've never been into that co-champion business. If somebody beat me 2 out of 3, they're the champion as far as I'm concerned. I understand they're getting the number one seed, and congratulations, you get a trophy, but that's not what it's all about. It's about we're the best.
Montana Tech, I'm not going to argue with you.
I'm just throwing my nickel worth out there.
Madison Allen will bring it into Cleverly. Tavi Aruni in the high post. Nia Falatoy out there with Danny Urich as well. Rooney, 13 feet out on the left wing. Passes it up top to Falatoy. Back into Rooney. Knocked to the ground. Rooney able to dribble clear, and now it's taken away. She tried the rifle pass to the baseline. Taken away by the Skylights. 2:12 left to play in the third.
Good heads-up defense by Northern.
Peyton Kerr, handoff to Skunk Cap. Skunk Cap top of the horn, looking for the backdoor cut, and that one's going to be thrown to no one again.
0-for-7.
Boy, they keep trying to work it. Peyton Kerr faked that she was going to come out to the wing and looked like she was going to turn and bust down towards the baseline. And she put on the brakes, and that one just skips into nothingness.
She put them on because the whole thing was taken away. The passer should have seen that.
2 minutes left to play here in the third. Around a screen, Cleverly down in the corner to Allen. Allen drifts up to the wing outside the arc. Madison Allen moving left. Pass in the corner. Tavi Aruni for three. Front of the rim, no good. Rebound, Lawrence. Montana Tech with 2 points this quarter as they trail 36-31. Into the offensive side, Lawrence around a screen, pass down in the bottom left corner. Now to the baseline, jump shot is up. That one's long for Crass. It goes out of play, and it will remain Skylight basketball.
Oh, I thought the Northern girl slapped it out of Urich's hands.
So here in the third quarter, Northern outscoring Montana Tech 8-2. Montana Tech still only down by 5, scoring 2 points this quarter. The inbound in the paint, trying to find an opening there is Riley Kerr. Her shot no good. Tavi Aruni with a rebound.
My favorite rebounder all time. She snatched that down with one hand.
Driving cleverly will put up the shot, excuse me. Tipped out, no good. And Northern with the rebound. Tech with one field goal this quarter. They just cannot buy one here over the last 8 minutes. Bounce pass into the high post, right elbow. Now they'll move it around the arc to Lawrence. Lawrence underneath to Crass. Crass gets it and finishes. Yeah, Cheyenne Crass has 8 points.
That is not a difficult cut to defend, and they just didn't get a body on her.
The Lights by 7. 50 seconds remaining here in the third. Tavia Rooney comes up top. Falatoy. Falatoy looking to the baseline. Passes left. Tavia Rooney. Rooney drives around a screen. Steps through. She'll attack. And her shot, no good, but she will go to the foul line as Cheyenne Crass will be called with a block.
It's exactly what I like to see Tavia Rooney do. She's a slasher, and she's real difficult to draw a charge on.
She walks out of there shaking her head. Boy, it's one of those feelings. We've all been there when nothing is going down. I mean, nothing is working for Tech right now as her first free throw, no good. Tech with 2 points this quarter, but again, they still only find themselves down by 7. Her second is good. She gets 1 of 2. Montana Tech trailing by 6, 38-32. Soda Rice will come in. Tavia Rooney is out. Full court pressure applied by the Oredigers. Three ladies in the backcourt. Lawrence will dribble it across midcourt. 30 seconds remaining here in the third quarter. Skylights up 38-32. Skylights with the basketball. They'll enter into the high post. Crass turns, double team. Hands it off, Skunk Cap. Nice pass through the paint. Nice finish by Riley Kerr.
Outstanding pass.
11 points for Riley Kerr. 13 seconds remaining in the third. Lights by 8. Around a screen. And cleverly steps back. She'll fire. Looks good. It rattles out. Rebound by the Skylights. 2 seconds. And Lawrence will fire from 80 to no avail. So with 10 minutes left in the ball game, the Skylights leading 40-32 over the Montana Tech Oredigers. The Skylights outscore Montana Tech 12-3 in the third quarter. We'll take a break. We'll start the fourth quarter after this 1 minute timeout. Hey, we're back here once again. Frontier Conference action. KBOW, KPQX. What does it take for us to be mocked by officials?
Do you know why I've never liked officials? There's one right there.
He's making fun of our faces. I didn't think officials could actually see anything.
I'll take care of him. I'll take care of him later.
Can you believe that?
He can't tee us up. That's a nice thing.
12-3, Skylights outscored Montana Tech in the third. Skylights will start with the ball here in the fourth quarter. Montana Tech shooting 25% from the floor. And now Brooke Hagee going to get a steal. They tried to get the entry pass. Hagee reaches through, gets the steal. Oredigger's into the offensive zone. Soda Rice down to the far right side to Allen. Madison Allen gets it off, driving, Cummings back to Allen. Three-point shot is up and short. Gets her own rebound following the shot and puts it down.
Maybe that's what Tech needed right there.
Madison Allen hard charges after her three-point attempt. She gets her own rebound on the easy putback. Tech down by 6, Skylights. Mason out near midcourt. Mason moving to her right. She'll hand it off there to Peyton Kerr. Peyton going to drive to the rack. Her shot no good. Allen with a rebound. Allen the other way, clears it out to Cleverly. Cleverly outside the arc, steps back. She'll go into the corner to Rice. Rice drives through the double team. Ball comes out. Skylights get the loose ball. Boy, I thought Cleverly was going to step back and launch it. She's been shooting the ball well.
Yeah. Yep, Rice forced the ball inside, got it slapped away.
Skylights by 6. They have the ball in the offensive zone. Riley Kerr, pass goes out on the right side. Skunk Cap now here on the near side to Mason. 8:38 left to play here in the ball game. Peyton Kerr down in the corner. Riley Kerr from downtown gets it. That's the second three of the contest here for the Skylights. Riley Kerr has 14 points.
Peyton Kerr's involvement in this second half has really made a big difference in this Northern's offensive output.
8:31 remaining here in the ball game. The Skylights are 2 of 15 from downtown, shooting 13%. Montana Tech, 3 of 16 from the three-point line, shooting 18% from the three-point line as of right now.
Overall, Montana Tech, I don't think, shooting very well, are they?
27%.
Yeah, they're really struggling with short-range jumpers and layups. It's one of those days. It's called a nightmare when you're a coach.
Yeah. On the let's take a look at our other scores here real quickly, see if we can get those updated for you. Frontier Conference action. Carroll is at Providence, and Rocky is hosting Western. Providence leads by 2, 53-51. That one basically right where we're at time-wise. And Rocky leading 62-36 over Western. That one's still in the third quarter.
That one is over.
Well, Steve, we got individual numbers here for Carroll and Providence. For Carroll College, Wagner has 12, Pickens with 11, Jaden Lyman has 10, Parker Esery has 22 points. She's 9 of 11 from the floor, 4 of 5 from the foul line. I was kind of surprised. I was expecting Parker Esery to have 22 points, so I went right to Pickens and fouls, and Pickens only has one. I really kind of expected there to be a foul issue there.
Well, it should be. She's getting 22. Somebody's got a hacker.
8:31 left to play here in this ball game. The Lights leading by 9, 43-34. As Montana Tech with the basketball. Cleverly into the offensive zone. Soda Rice passes out wide left to Jaden Cummings. Cummings feeds it on the inside to Hege. Hege fights her way to the rack and gets it in.
That's the first time she got her feet in the paint. Easy layup.
8 points on the night for Hege. Lights leading 43-36. Down the floor, into the corner, is Toms. Toms comes out to Lawrence. Lawrence still scoreless here in this ball game. Goes to the left elbow, Peyton Kerr. Peyton looking down the left side of the paint. She'll attack. Good defensive pressure by Cummings as she reaches in and knocks that one away. As Jaden Cummings, graduating as a sophomore. I think that one threw some people off here this last weekend. She's on paper as a redshirt sophomore, so she has her redshirt year and also her COVID year. She is going to graduate in engineering in 4 years.
That's pretty amazing.
Driving with the left hand is Morgan Mason, and Mason will roll it in. She has 10 points.
Mason is a smart player.
9-point lead the other way. Montana Tech feeds it into Danny Urich, and she will finish. Danny Urich, 13 points. She is the leading scorer for Montana Tech right now. 7:35 left to play in the ball game. Skylights by 7. Montana Tech's starting to heat up here a little bit, you hope.
Somebody's got to get the hot hand for him.
Toms to Lawrence. Lawrence outside the arc. Cleverly on her defensively. They move it here on the near side. Backdoor cut to Lawrence. She rolls it off the glass and in.
Tech is really getting beaten by that high screen on the backside.
Lawrence gets her first field goal as she rolls that one off the glass. Danny Urich at the top of the horn. Tavia Rooney back into the ball game as well. Danny Urich steps inside, drives through the paint. Ball fake goes up. Boy, she goes down hard. Montana Tech stays in possession. Molly Peoples right wing up top to Rooney. Ball fake. Rooney steps in 16 feet out. No good. Lawrence grabs the rebound.
Tech shooting woes really are continuing.
6:45 left to play here in the ball game. Tech shooting 28% from the floor. Skylights at 42% from the floor. Pass goes to Lawrence. Neither team can get anything going outside the three-point line today. In the high post, pass goes there to Hovde. Hovde moves it down to the corner. Three-point shot, Peyton Kerr, no good. Rebound controlled, Allie Cleverly. 6:20 remaining in the ball game. Cleverly throws it right to Urich. Urich down to the corner, Rooney. Rooney, bottom right corner, now into Hege. She draws a loose double team. Cross court to Danny Urich. She'll fire from downtown. Danny Urich gets another one.
And that's part of it. That's the first time they've really been inside out tonight. And Urich all alone back there. Nice pass, nice shot.
16 points for Danny Urich. And the Lights lead by 6. 5:50 left to play here in this ball game. Hovde up top. Tom goes right side. Now they feed it in the block, taken away by Hege. Good defense again by Hege. Down the floor quickly in transition. Urich gets just taken out. Danny Urich gets wiped out underneath the basket, and she'll go to the line and shoot a pair.
That's an outstanding pass. Urich's tough. She's from Belt, Montana. She's tough.
So Urich will take a couple deep breaths, and she'll go to the foul line. As we all know, I would still be on the floor weeping.
Nope.
Urich?
No comment.
Probably more of a sob, really, than a weep, wouldn't it be?
I think it's a lot of tears coming out of you.
17 points on the day for Danny Urich. And I would assume you're still going to say, and because I agree, she hasn't shot enough.
Never does.
Her second is good. 18 points on the day for Danny Urich. And her high point, let's get this out here real quickly. Her high point in her career is 22 points. That came against Northern last year.
Well, Tech is back in this game, and right now there's two people that have control of the ball. Urich and Tavia Aruni.
5:30 left to play here in the contest. The Lights lead by four. Montana Tech with some momentum. Lawrence here near side to Mason. Mason into the high post to Toms. She'll wrap around. Right side of the paint. Shot no good. Hagee with good defensive presence again. And here come the digs in transition. Switch dribble to the baseline. Cummings had the ball knocked away from her. She'll kick it out on the wing. Three-point shot. Cleverly gets it again. Allie cleverly knocks down the three. Cleverly shooting 45% from the three-point line. She has 6 points. The digs within one. They were ice cold in the third, coming to life here in the fourth. Lights up 47-46. Lights lob it into Hovde. Nice take by Hovde. She'll get it off the glass.
Biggest part of that play, she didn't try to catch it with one hand. She caught it in two and put it right up.
Great patience after she brought it in. Lights by three. Danny Urich to Rooney. Back to Urich, far right wing. She'll square up. Three-point shot, no good. Defensive rebound, Lawrence. And here come the Lights back the other way. Pass down to the bottom right side. Prather now inside to Hovde. Hovde spins around the screen and gets another one.
Easy transition, fast break. The bigs ran the floor for Northern.
Lights by five. 4:15 left to play in the ball game. Lights shooting 44% from the floor. Montana Tech up to 32%. Tavia Rooney, left side of the paint, turns and fires, no good. Rebound tipped. Cummings comes out with it. Cummings tries to get separation, puts up the shot, no good. And the Skylights grab the rebound.
Cummings should have kicked it to the three-point shooter.
Lights lead by five, 51-46. Hovde gets the entry. Right elbow, cross court to Lawrence. 3:45 left to play here in the ball game. The Lights again leading by five. They go to Hovde at the foul line. She'll shoot from there. No good. A rare miss for her today. Rebound, Danny Urich.
Great block out by Danny Urich.
That is Hovde's first miss tonight. Baseline take. Cleverly with the floater. Goes behind the backboard and out of play. And that will be Northern basketball. 3:26 left to play here in the ball game. Lights up 51-46. Couple substitution. Both Kerrs will come in here. They have Mason on the floor with Lawrence and Hovde. On the other side for Montana Tech, Cummings cleverly, Danny Urich, Tavia Rooney, and Brooke Hagee. Mason busts into the offensive zone, needs a little help. She'll pass it to her right side, Peyton Kerr. 3:15 remaining. Kerr spins to her left hand underneath, pass to Hovde, bobbled for a moment. She'll kick it out on the corner. Riley Kerr back into Hovde. Hovde double team to the wing. Peyton Kerr, shot clock at six. Peyton lost the handle, out of bounds. Tech ball. Good defensive stand that time by the Digs, and they'll get it back.
Tech needs a big shot here on this possession.
When Montana Tech has grabbed momentum, Northern has answered. Into the offensive side, Cummings far left wing, feeds it into Urich. Urich attacks the basket. No, she got the shot up. No whistle, no foul. The rebound controlled by Hagee. And we're going to get a whistle underneath here as Hagee and Hovde were knotted up. Possession arrow will favor the Skylights. Boy, that battle inside is physical.
And they both know it.
2:48 remaining here in the ball game. The inbound, Danny Urich comes up top. Now into Hagee. Hagee turns to her left, gets separation, shot rolls out. Northern ball.
the dilemma for Tech today. They're not going to watch film on missed layups today. They're not going to like it.
2:30 remaining here in the ball game. Skylights left side, Peyton Kerr. Peyton dribbling around to high screen, top of the horn, down the right side, leaves it out on that edge to Riley Kerr. Riley to Lawrence. Lawrence here on the near side. 10 on the shot clock. Lawrence stops in the elbow, kicks it out to Mason. Three ball is up and short. Tavia Rooney with a rebound. She'll outlet quickly. Rebound number 10 for Tavia Rooney today. Cummings coast to coast across the baseline, draws the foul.
They need to do a highlight film on Tavia Rooney's rebounding. It's real special.
So Tavia Rooney, 10 rebounds on the day. She has the individual record for rebounds in a season at 337 rebounds her freshman year. Last year, she added to that number. And right now, she has, coming into this ball game, she had 245 rebounds, so she has 255 rebounds currently. And her rebounding numbers continue to climb as she finds herself the number one rebounding season in Tech history, now the number three rebounding season this year. Jaden Cummings goes one of two from the foul line. Lights lead by four. Lawrence across the timeline. Under 2 minutes left to play here in this ball game. Skylights Hovde right at the top of the horn. Hovde has Hagee on her. Hovde moving left, hands it off to Lawrence. Around a screen, three ball, no good. And Hovde grabs a rebound high, lost it. It goes out of bounds. Tech basketball.
Off her foot.
1:44 left to play here in the ball game. The lights up 51-47. Cummings will go out. Madison Allen will come in.
Tech's got to run their stuff here. Ball's got to go inside out.
Across the timeline, cleverly lost it. Drives into the paint, puts it up off balance. She gets wiped out, goes to the floor. And she will go to the line and shoot two.
She got a break there. She lost control of the ball and had to stop. The defender run right over her.
She came into the key and just completely lost the handle on it. She wanted to pass it and then try to get it back under control and just was never able to grab it. So at the foul line, cleverly shooting her first free throw of the day. It's up and in. Good cleverly, 7 points.
Good free throw shooter.
She'll get the ball for attempt number two. Lights leading 51-48. Cleverly's second is on the way and good. Cleverly goes 2 of 2. She has 8 points on the day. The lights up 51-49. Full court pressure. Lawrence trap coming. Dribbles out, pass knocked out, but quickly picked up by Mason. Mason down to the bottom right corner. As Kerr to Mason, back up to Lawrence. Excuse me. Three wide, high-low post. Now they bring two into the high post for the Skylights. Mason to Hovde. Hovde, right wing to Lawrence. 10 on the shot clock. 1:18 remaining in the ball game. Down to the block they go. Underneath to Riley Kerr. She goes with the left hand. No good. Rebound tip, Tavia Rooney.
You got to take her time. She's in too big a hurry.
Madison Allen quickly into the offensive zone. Puts on the brakes. 1:04 remaining in the ball game. Lights by two. Cleverly has Mason on her. Man-to-man defense. Pass goes left. Danny Urich. Urich with 18 points, lobs it into Hagee. Hagee turns to her right, gets it, and gets the foul. Brooke Hagee has 10. We're tied at 51. Hagee a chance for the lead.
The neat thing about that is a proper pass. It went away from the defender. She did not have a chance to stop that play at all because of the pass.
So Brooke Hagee at the line. Hagee is 2 of 3 from the free throw line here today. And she will step up. Southpaw rattles out. 51 all our score. The third time we have been tied here today. 45 seconds remaining in the ball game. Lawrence up top, enters to Hovde at the left elbow. She'll step back. Up top there to Riley Kerr. Now on the right side to Lawrence. Inside, knocked out of bounds, Hagee. They tried to force feed it to Hovde. Didn't use the skip pass, and Hagee is able to punch that one out of bounds.
1 inch difference between a layup and a ball knocked out of bounds.
Northern looking to bring it in. Pass comes out on the right side. Now it comes out to Peyton Kerr. 33 on the game clock, 10 on the shot clock. Around the screen, Lawrence down the left side of the paint. Lawrence shot blocked. Whistle and a foul. They're going to get Hagee.
Hagee got her with the body.
So Hagee will get her fourth personal foul, and that will put Lawrence at the line. So Latia Lawrence, a 75% free throw shooter on the year, has not shot any here today. She only has 2 points, and her first is up and good. Skylights lead 52-51.
Tech needs Molly Peoples in here right now.
At the foul line, Lawrence gets ready for her second. It's on its way and good. Lawrence goes 2 of 2, and Montana Tech will call a timeout. 53-51, the Skylights up over Montana Tech with 27 seconds remaining here in the ball game. Boy, we couldn't buy a basket there in the third quarter, and all of a sudden here in the fourth, the shooting percentages have gone up dramatically, at least over that third quarter.
Well, everybody likes to win, and so all of a sudden you turn up your game a little bit, but right now, my own vision is they've got to have 2 3-point shooters on the perimeter. Get Tavia Rooney the ball and get her to go to the hoop. Kick it into Hagee if you have. Don't. Hagee's going to be doubled, so she's got to kick it right back out and allow for the drive or a good 3-point look from Danny Urich. I'd love to see Molly Peoples in there right now.
Montana Tech trailing by 2. They'll inbound the ball in their offensive zone with 27 seconds remaining in the ball game. No shot clock. The other game's underway tonight. Providence is hosting Carroll. That one with just a little over a minute remaining. Providence leads 69-67. That place has to be a madhouse right now. And Rocky all over Western 73-47. That one about 4 minutes remaining in the fourth quarter.
Well, Rocky's been the team this year. It really has. Wes Keller's done an outstanding job there.
Lights by 2, 53-51. Frontier Conference action here on KBOW, KPQX. Montana Tech will have the ball in their offensive zone. Danny Urich, Brooke Hagee, Tavia Rooney, Madison Allen, and Allie Cleverly on the floor for the Digs. Mason, Hovde, both Cares, and Lawrence on the floor for the Skylights. The inbound, Danny Urich, 27 seconds. Lob pass to Hagee at the top of the key. She'll hand it off to Urich. Urich all the way out to the left wing. Up top, Rooney. Rooney feeds it into Hagee. Hagee turns, right hand, shot no good. Rebound battled for, and the Skylights come down with it, and a whistle and a foul. Hagee will pick up her fifth, as coming down with that ball was Riley Kerr.
She had to do that.
Yeah, exactly.
She had a good look. It was her move to put in.
So Hagee will foul out of this ball game. Brooke Hagee will go to the bench with 10 points, 13.9 seconds remaining. And the Skylights will inbound. That was only the second team foul on Montana Tech. Skylights, we're going to get a whistle and a foul before the inbound. That's team foul number 3.
Smart foul. They've got to get it up around so that fifth one's necessary. They should foul 2 more times right here without letting the ball get in.
Yeah, with you on that. Team foul number 3. Skylights get the ball for the inbound. Peyton Kerr to Hovde. Hovde hands it off to Lawrence. 12 seconds down to 11. Whistle and a foul. Lawrence able to take a couple seconds off the clock there. Lights leading 53-51. And the next one will put the Skylights at the line.
Ideally, they want Hovde with the ball. She's not that great a free throw shooter.
So a short timeout here by the Digs. An update from Great Falls. Carroll now leads by 1. 70-69 with 53 seconds remaining. Let's take a look at individual numbers from that game. Pickens has 15. Lyman with 14. Wagner has 14. On the other side, Parker Esery, 27. Emily Maldonado with 14 as Carroll leads by 1 in that contest in Great Falls. So Rocky right now up by 27 with 2 minutes left. They will be the Frontier Conference co-champs. They will be the number 1 seed.
Yes.
So if you want to win the Frontier Conference on the women's side, you've got to do it at some point in Billings.
Yeah, the comforts of home, and that's a reality in the game of basketball.
So after the timeout, Skylights will inbound. Again, both teams have 4 team fouls. Trying to get it in. They do so to Hovde in the backcourt. Hovde going to be fouled. Nia Falatoy gets her. So they're looking for Hovde the whole way there. Let's take a look at Hovde's numbers here. Hovde, a 71% free throw shooter on the year.
What is she today? 1 for 3?
She's 3 of 5.
3 of 5, okay. Well, the comfort of what's going on, she gets to shoot 2. So that's real important. She makes 1 of them.
So Hovde gets the ball for her 2 attempts here. The lights up 53-51. Hovde's first money.
She has played well here today. She is a beast down on that block.
I'll tell you, I could watch she and Hagee battle all day. They're both so good. both so sound and strong. Hovde goes 2 of 2. The lights go up by 4. 55-51 with 10 seconds remaining. Montana Tech will call a timeout. They'll inbound out near midcourt on our side of the court here. So the lights leading 55-51. The lights looking to go to 2-13 in conference to end the regular season.
Yeah, Montana Tech's got to go to the hoop. A three's not going to do them much justice because it's going to bring Northern back to the free throw line. Tavy Rooney's got to get the ball. They got to clear out an area for her, let her go to the hoop, and whatever happens, happens.
55-51. Game here, game one of our doubleheader on KBOW, KPQX. Texas Tech has outscored Northern 19-15 here in this fourth quarter, but they had to dig out of a big hole there in the third quarter. There's only 3 points for the Digs in that third quarter. Lights lead by 4, 55-51. Danny Urich gets the ball for the inbound. Urich trying to get an opening. Pass to Allen. Allen baseline, fires from 15. That one goes long. It's tipped out to the wing, and it goes into the hands of Urich to Tavia Rooney. 2 seconds to Cleverly from downtown. No good, and that's going to do it. Our final 55-51. The Skylights of MSU Northern will get the win over Montana Tech. They'll take 2 of 3 from the Montana Tech Oredigers here on the season, and they won both of theirs on this floor. Montana Tech won in the Armory in the first matchup. 55-51, our final. The lights up over the Digs here on KBOW, KPQX. We'll take a timeout. We'll come back. We'll wrap this game one up after this 1 minute timeout. Back here once again at the campus of Montana Tech. Our final, the Skylights get the win 55-51 over Montana Tech. Skylights will end the regular season at 9-20 overall, 2-13 in Frontier Conference play. The Digs will end at 12-18 overall and 3-12 in Frontier Conference play with a 55-51 loss here to the Skylights this evening.
Crazy basketball game. I haven't seen one like this in a long time. A lot of opportunities. Texas went ice cold in that third quarter and it cost them. You can't fight back all the time, but they had their opportunities and didn't take advantage of them. I really liked Hovde as the player of the game. She did a great job on the block, did a great job rebounding, and really played great defense.
She ended up being their leading scorer. She gets 15 points in this ball game, does Hovde for MSU Northern. She was 5 of 6 from the floor. She had 13 rebounds. She was a monster for her minutes on the floor tonight.
And the defense she played made a difference. You know, you're not going to stop every post player, but she really put enough pressure on to cause problems.
Also for the Skylights, Riley Kerr gets 14 on the night. Morgan Mason with 10. Latia Lawrence gets 4 points. Peyton Kerr with 4. It looks like Cheyenne Crass with 8 points. And I miss Morgan Mason. 10 points on the night for Morgan Mason. 7 of those coming in the opening quarter as the Skylights put 55 on the board in a win here today. On the other side for Montana Tech, Danny Urich with 18 points on the day. Just a great ball game for her. She scored the first 5 points for Montana Tech. Those 5 points got her to 1,000 lifetime. So she will join that 1,000-point club here for Montana Tech as Danny Urich goes over 1,000 here in her final regular season game for Montana Tech.
Oh, I absolutely love that girl as a player. She's heady. She's a good IQ player, good shooter. Doesn't shoot enough. Drives me crazy, but Coaches are born to be driven crazy.
Also for the Digs, Allie Cleverly will finish with 8 points here today. Molly Peoples with three. Madison Allen will get 2 points. Tavy Rooney with 7 points on the day. Let's take a look at her rebounding numbers Rooney with 7 points, 10 rebounds here on the day. Brooke Hagee with 10 points when she fouled out. Hagee had 9 rebounds, so 10 points, 9 rebounds for her. And Nia Fallatoy, 1 basket, 2 points for her as the Skylights get the win, 55-51, as they take down Montana Tech in the final regular season game. Again, Montana Tech knows that they will be at Western for their playoff game, and right now we still don't know the other one. Currently, the Carroll-Providence game in Great Falls is tied 73-all with 9 seconds left.
Oh.
And I don't know who has possession.
Well, could you make a phone call, because I'm interested in that.
Carroll-Providence tied up 73-all with 9 seconds remaining there. So the Skylights get the win in game one of our doubleheader, 55-51 over the Montana Tech Oredigers here on KBOW, KPQX. Let's send it back to our studios for a little bit, ladies and gentlemen. We'll get our books ready. We'll get ready for the men's game and more. We'll be back here in 10 minutes.